Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Deborah Tonya Edet, but you can call me IB. Now, are you interested in learning the simple aspects of transcribing? Then you're on the right channel. Just click the subscription button below and the notification bell to get notifications on my next videos. In our first three videos, we had an introduction to transcribing, the three P's the transcriber should possess, and the required tools to have as a transcriber. Now, if you missed any of these videos and would like to watch them again, just see the description below. Now, our next lesson is on the two types of transcription. Now, there are two types of transcriptions. We have verbatim transcription and non-verbatim transcription. Today's video will focus on verbatim transcription. What is verbatim transcription? Verbatim transcription is capturing every word or sound heard from the audio file you are transcribing. Now, these words or sounds include interjections and utterances from other speakers. They include false starts. They include speech fillers like all those stuff. Stuttering also. Now, these include non-verbal sounds like laughter, coughing, sneezing, and other ambient sounds. Now, it is important you clarify from your client the kind of transcripts they expect from you. Now, it could be that your client could be working on a kind of research or a legal matter, and verbatim transcripts is always good for this sort of clients because every single word, every single sound, every single utterance or sound captured there could be very, very critical for their purpose. For example, it could even be a legal client you're working for or a court case, for instance. If someone on the stand happened to stutter or maybe kind of paused or hesitated in answering some questions, these little things, if you indicate them in your transcript, they go a long way in helping to determine the mindset or the issue of the subject in question or the person in question. You know, these little things matter, you know. So these are very, very important for those clients if they require verbatim transcripts. Now, verbatim transcript also is mostly used in legal and medical transcription because of vital important, you know, information being captured there in this transcript. They are very, very vital. A patient could be with a doctor and a doctor, you know, records the conversation between him and his client. Now, how the client responds, like we said earlier, how the client responds will go a long way to indicate and let us know the mindset of the patient. Don't forget verbatim. Today we are focusing on verbatim transcription, and they are very key for legal matters, medical issues, and probably even research group purposes. Now, this kind of transcript is very crucial. You need to capture every sound. If someone sneezed, you capture it. If someone coughed, you capture it. If someone hesitated in responding to a question, you capture it. If there's any sort of interjection, it should be captured. All this will help with your clients in knowing how to handle certain things they are doing. They need the purpose they need this information for. So that will be all for today. And if you did learn something new, if you learned something today, please don't forget to comment in the comment section. If you have questions, please don't fail to ask. I will try as much as possible to answer as much as I am able to. Our next video will be looking at non-verbatim transcripts. Until then, this is me signing out. Bye.